Hey guys, this is Kashish Nana Arya working as an intern at Pixel Labs. So today I'm going to talk to you about the introduction to Salesforce Sales Cloud. A Salesforce Sales Cloud is one in every of the enterprise product offerings by Salesforce.com. Sales Cloud from Salesforce is an enterprise product where it provides a beautiful platform to manage the end-to-end functioning of the sales division for a corporation, like logging the merchandise information, managing the customer contacts, creating campaigns, triggering emails, dashboard features, reports, creation of order and opportunities, supported progression, deals with customers, and lots of more. So following are the important features of Salesforce Sales Cloud. The first one is campaign management. Campaign management in Salesforce helps in projecting the organization's marketing programs that are targeted to get better revenues in lieu of its campaigning programs. Samples of campaign programs are advertisements, emails, seminars, events, telemarketing, and etc. Second one is leads management. Now, allow us to suppose as a result of your campaigning event, few of the shoppers have shown interest as a result of your marketing promotion. For example, you had founded a campaign to sell laptops at a reduced price and few customers showed interest in the deal and registered their name to be contacted. A lead within the Sales Cloud could be a potential customer who has shown interest in buying a company's product or services as a result of campaigning, or out of their own interest, but they will not be fully qualified for getting yet. They may be shoppers with whom the corporate has never done any business, are the hence a possible customer. Next one is about the accounts management. Now, it's a definitely possible that a lead won't be the sole one who should be fully answerable for initiating the deal and driving till its closure. There may be many persons involved, including the finance and the infrastructure teams yet. Accounts are organizations with whom you are visiting make a trade. For example, there is an organization with the name DX and that they have an interest in your products. So you may now create an account with this name. Again, the way to create an account is extremely the same as creating the campaigns and the leads. Now the next one is contacts management. When an account is about to open, we also require to line up and maintain the contacts of key businesses that are involved and driving your trade. There is also a choice to tag the contacts to an already existing account. The next one is opportunities management. When the talks with the account are at a stage where you as a product offering see it because the right time to take a chance for the dealings, it is done through the opportunity management, which is largely the name of the deal. For example, 2000 laptop selling deal. We are required to say at what stage this chance currently is. The next one is cases management. When the deal gets finalized, it's almost happening that the account is coming with the issues they need to be encountered for your products. For example, OS not found it properly for laptops, defects in a very laptop, etc. The cases are accustomed to file and track issues that are coming from clients or the customers. There is severity, the contact who raised the complaint, the account to which this issue belongs to, and etc. Now the last thing is reports and the dashboards. This section helps to form reports and dashboards. Generally, the organization's senior members use this section to drill down and find if regular campaigns are happening and if campaigns are gaining leads and accounts, if good revenue is being generated as a result of marketing, promotions, and etc. So guys, that's all for now. Thank you for watching this video. If you are looking for a Salesforce consulting services, check Pixel Apps. The link is in the description.